In this video, we're going to talk about AI, crypto coins, and that's artificial intelligence, which I'm sure you're aware this year we've seen a massive surge in activity. Remember, nothing I say on this video is financial advice. Always do your own research before investing any of your own money. Let's get into it, guys. Now, in the start of 2023, we've seen a lot of exciting things happening with AI. We've seen the rise of ChatGPT, as well as other incredible AI projects. And it's unsurprising to see crypto basically getting into the AI world as well. We've seen a lot of activity trading on the crypto markets, particularly in the AI tokens over the last few weeks. But recently, we've seen a little bit of a pullback in those tokens, which gives us a great opportunity to take a look at them and see whether they're going to be good investments going forward. Now, the first one we're going to look at today is SingularityNET, which we can see over here on CoinMarketCap, currently down 4% on the day with a market cap of just under $500 million. Now, SingularityNET is an Ethereum and Cardano based AI marketplace, allowing people to create their own AI products and sell them on this marketplace. Now, this is very cool because it supports a lot of people who are being able to now create these incredible AI tools. And there's so many different things in which AI is starting to be used for that the possibilities are endless. Now, what we can see down here is you can search, trial, and select from an ever-growing library of AI algorithms created by a community of service providers. Now, basically what this means is there's loads of talented developers out there who are able to create some of the very coolest and most useful AI-based technologies. However, they may not have access to being able to sell it onto the open market. And this is where SingularityNET comes in, because it enables the creators to share their products with consumers. And this is a very useful tool. And it's why we've seen SingularityNET seeing some good growth recently. And when we look into the AGIX chart, you can see that we haven't got a huge amount of data here because it hasn't been traded for a huge amount of time. But along with Bitcoin and the rest of the crypto market, since back in January, we've already seen a push that was up 11x at one point, currently sat 641% up since just January. And this is indicative of what I think is to come within the crypto market. As we see Bitcoin, etc., pushing, you can see just back to this all-time high for AGIX here would be up 60%. And there's no doubt we're going to see some insane growth going forward for this particular token. The next token we're going to talk about today is Fetch.Ai. Again, having a little bit of a dip, down 5% on the day, with a market cap here of $352 million. It's obviously not small and has been around for a little bit of time, but again, I expect to see Fetch having an incredible year. Now, Fetch is a very, very cool project indeed. It's an autonomous agent technology, power peer-to-peer applications with automation and AI capabilities with or without direct access to the blockchain. Now, Fetch basically offers a decentralized machine learning to provide innovative solutions for agents to act upon. Now, you're probably wondering what that really means. Well, every time you're using an app, say you're using like a delivery app or you're using like another app, for example, like Uber, this is a product that's going to be able to support those particular different projects. So every time you're using an Uber or something like that, it's actually going to gather data about the users that are using that particular app in order to feed back into a system and create a huge amount of data, which it can then analyze. And this is going to enable it to create a better service going forward. This information can be fed back to not only the consumer in order for the consumer to enjoy a better service, but also for the provider. Okay, so the provider is going to be able to create a better service as well, a more efficient service. This will ultimately increase the profitability for the provider, enabling them to cut down the costs, which are obviously better than for the consumer. And the Fetch ecosystem is basically powered by the FET token, which is used as a medium of exchange across the entire platform. Now, unlike AGIX, FET has been around for a little bit of time now, and we can see that it's been through various bull and bear markets. And interestingly, you can see it follows a similar pattern to Bitcoin, however, and seeing far bigger spikes and far bigger drops towards the downside. If you look, however, at where we are in the whole kind of like pattern of things, you can see that we had an all-time high here about $1.19, which from current levels is another push of 173%. We have actually, however, seen a very big push in the FET price in the last few weeks or so, where we are currently up 380% from the start of the recent kind of bull phase that we are in right now. Given the interest that's coming in the AI space right now, you can see that Fetch will definitely be pushing back to all-time highs and, in my opinion, way beyond into the future. Looking into our next token then, we're going to look at the graph. Currently up 1.4% on the day with a market cap of $1.3 billion and sat in the number 40 position. So here we are over on thegraph.com, and everything I talk about about today is linked down below in the description if you want to go and check them out afterwards, guys. The APIs for a vibrant decentralized future. The graph is an indexing protocol for querying networks like Ethereum and IPFS. Anyone can build and publish open APIs called subgraphs, making data easily accessible. And the graph itself is a collection of different subgraphs which developers can come and use in order to create different types of queries on the Ethereum blockchain. Now, what's really cool about the graph is it enables entrepreneurs, etc., to create really exciting future apps and then scale human coordination on the internet. This is kind of feeding into the Web3 environment, which I'm sure this year is going to be insane in terms of the growth that you're going to see. So by combining Web3 protocols, developers can build dApps with powerful new features for solving the world's greatest challenges. It's ultra fast, affordable, and secure, and it's basically enabling developers to create incredible products going forward that are going to see incredible growth going into this year. And I think it's because of that Web3 growth and the kind of the uprising of AI itself that we're going to see products like the Graph really taking off. Now, Graph is one crypto that we've seen have a huge boom and then bust, and that's pretty much what we've seen across the crypto market, so it's nothing to worry about too much. But that gives us a good idea of where Graph can potentially go in the future, because previously it came all the way up to $2.8 and it's currently just valued at around 15 cents. So back to all-time highs, you're looking at an 18x, and I think Graph is potentially going to see even higher gains beyond that. And one way we can look at that, guys, is to take a Fibonacci retracement from the swing high and drop it down to the swing low point. And that gives us the 1.618, which is the golden ratio, okay, Fibonacci's golden ratio. And this will tell us that we could potentially go from here all the way up to the 1.618, which is a 26x on the Graph price going forward. And when it comes to crypto, guys, I know a lot of it might be a bit technical and difficult to understand, but I myself am a trader. I focus a lot more on the kind of trading side of things. And pretty much most cryptos right now, if they survive the bear market, are likely to see incredible gains, at least back to all-time highs and probably beyond. And that's why the crypto market right now is such an exciting time to be involved. And if you want to know more about how to trade in different projects, Web3, NFTs, and much, much more, then make sure you're subscribed to the channel, guys, because we talk about this every single day and there's some great opportunities to get involved with. And the last crypto we're going to talk about today is Ocean Protocol, again, linked down below in the description, currently a market cap of $245 million. That's actually pretty small and it gives us a good opportunity to see some growth over time. Now, the Ocean Protocol basically is a kind of a huge data library. So if you need access to some specific data, then you can pay in Ocean tokens to be able to access that data and then use it in order to build your projects. Now, you're probably wondering, well, who would want to do that? Well, data itself is one of the most valuable things going. If you think about the likes of Google, the likes of Amazon and other huge companies, they all rely heavily on data, and that's what enables them to provide you with the very best service. So when you're next sifting through Facebook or you're next sifting through Google, you'll notice often that you get hit up with some information and you get hit up with products that maybe you're just sort of thinking about getting hold of, and this is all through the use of data. And because they're able to put products in front of you when you actually want to consume them, well, it's good for you because it means you don't have to go looking for it, but it's also good for the company that's trying to sell it because they can connect you with the right product. And this comes through understanding huge data and being able to process that huge data and give it to the right people at the right time. So you can see open market is a decentralized market to publish data and consume data. And another thing about data itself is data obviously is quite a large, bulky thing. It's quite difficult for the individual to study data and understand it. And this is where machine learning, AI, etc. can come in and make huge, arduous tasks into something very, very simple. And Ocean has already been recognized in the New York Times, the BBC, Forbes, as well as various others. And it's an on and off ramp for data assets into DeFi. It enables people who've already collected the data to be able to list that data or create data libraries on the Ocean Protocol, which is great news because they can then sell their data to Ocean Protocol, who can then sell it on to other consumers. But what's crucial is that we look at this point down here, and this is a big thing that AI is starting to bring in, is that it's able to provide data to various consumers, but on a strictly private basis. So I myself might be feeding in data to a machine through the different habits I'm doing. For example, maybe the different things that I'm purchasing, maybe the different things or websites that I'm looking at, all feed into a data loop that can be used to create a better service, not just for me, but other people in a network. But it's actually able to provide that data back without specifying where it came from or who is actually using it, which makes it kind of private, and therefore I'm not losing my privacy rights, which is obviously important as well, and maybe a big concern of people in general. Now, in summary, those are four crypto tokens which I've already seen surging towards the upside this year. And that's indicative, I think, of what we're about to see happening to AI and Web3 cryptocurrencies going forward. It's definitely worth going and visiting all of the websites we've talked about today, which are all linked down below, in order to get into the detail and understand whether or not those are potential investments investments for you. If you don't want to invest in them, that's fine, but it's definitely worth understanding where AI is going and all the opportunity that it's going to provide us with going forward. Guys, if you enjoyed today's video, then hit that like button for me. If you're new to the channel, you want to learn more about crypto trading, NFTs, AI, crypto, Web3, and much, much more, then hit subscribe, and I'll see you in the very next video. Bye-bye.